As a beginner, what is the best possible way to invest your first $100 in the volatile crypto market? Especially with very little knowledge and sometimes no experience, it can be difficult to determine whether you are investing the right way or not. That is why today in our video, we will be giving you some points to consider and how to invest your first $100 in the crypto market. Disclaimer: remember, this should not be considered as financial advice, as they are based on research. One of the best decisions as a beginner, individual, or entity who wants to invest in crypto can make is to start small and make use of exchanges with easy-to-use interfaces. Investing small amounts over a given period of time enables you to reduce your risk and thoroughly learn through the processes before you decide to make huge investments. There is the process known as dollar cost averaging, DCA, which essentially is taking small amounts of money and investing the same amount at regular intervals over time till the end of the investment time horizon. The advantage here is that since it is a long-term strategy, profits are compounded over time as long as the asset you are investing in is also compounding. For individuals who earn daily or weekly wages, this method is quite suitable. The Bitcoin exchange also allows its users to make recurring Bitcoin buys on a regular schedule. If you are going to invest in cryptocurrencies with as little as $100, you will want to check for trading fees as well. Choosing an exchange that will give you low and reliable fees, like Binance and Kraken, is essential for beginners. Blockchains have different fees, and so you can decide to own a crypto wallet and make payments using the blockchain. When you are investing $100 in crypto, the importance of researching how many coins there will be in lockup periods cannot be overemphasized. Depending on your investment plan, you can choose an exchange like Coinbase, which allows you to trade between different cryptos and buy Bitcoin. The Robinhood exchange, for example, offers the chance to trade Bitcoin commission-free on a 24-hour basis each day. CoinMarketCap or CoinGeek also gives information about the coin you want to invest in, the price, and in general how much the project is. This can be looked up if you search on Google and the trading platforms. The bigger the project, the more validated and secure it appears to be, especially when numerous investment parties are also involved. Tokenomics, as it is popularly called, is a term used to describe how a token is used inside a project ecosystem or how the token will follow a monetary policy as it grows over time. It basically covers all aspects involving coin creation and management. Tokenomics is another aspect to know when looking for a reliable exchange to invest your coins. The token supply of the team, founding sale, which usually goes to the founders of the project or some very early investors, and the community are worth checking. The healthier the project, the higher the amount of secondary supply in the secondary market. Well, one might claim to have heard of passive income and be wondering how safe it is, and whether as an investor who is just beginning in the crypto space, it is necessary to be aware of passive income. Staking, or otherwise known as passive income, allows you to put your coins up for a given period, about 50, 60 days or ongoing, and then you will receive some passive income in return. Binance once again is suitable and gives you the chance to buy cryptocurrency at a low cost on the exchange and then use the earning platform directly to earn extra passive income under cryptos. Certain cryptos do not allow for lending, buying or staking, and you need to watch out for these. Centralized lending platforms like BlockFi, where you can earn 5% extra passive income, as well as Ethereum Exchange, can be used if you prefer to keep your coins on centralized platforms. Remember, however, that for centralized platforms, they may not always be safe for investors, as addresses can be frozen at times because they are controlled and regulated by the government. This brings us to the end of our session today. We hope to come your way another time with nothing but great content. Remember to subscribe to this channel, and if you like the video, leave a thumbs up for us. Enjoy the rest of your time.